Hello, everyone. I'll give you a minute to get in and get settled. Welcome. Glad you are in. Make sure you can hear me okay. And of course, as you are coming in the chat, if you want to just let me know, have you started updating any of your decks yet? Or have you not started? Have you finished? You've created new decks maybe after our last webinar. But hello and welcome. Thank you all for being here today. Whether it's day or nighttime by you, we do appreciate that you are coming to these to kind of learn more about accessibility and how we can create those in your Boom decks. As you are logging in, I do want to let you know that this will be recorded. So if you need to leave early or if you want to watch this at another time, maybe slower, pause it, you can do that. There will be a replay that will come out in the next days so that you can see that as well. So again, as you're getting in, just let me know where are you at, kind of an A, B, C, or D with updating accessibility for your decks. Just make sure the chat feature works. Hello, it sounds like somebody can hear me. That's good. Yes. Totally. Added accessibility to 140 decks. That's awesome. B and C. Yep, a little bit of I've started, maybe of getting towards finishing, but I have some new ideas maybe. Love that. Awesome. I'm glad we are doing this. This is great. Because again, you are going to be making sure that your decks are more accessible for more students. Love that. Cool. Great. Well, let's get started. Let's not waste any time. Tonight, it is just me. So, for the sake of all the things, please make sure you are using the Q&A feature for all the questions that you have tonight. So that way I can find them all in one place. Because again, it is just me tonight. So, I want to make sure that we can get to all your questions in a timely manner. So, of course, we are going to spend a lot of time talking about audio accessibility tonight. So, please, all your questions be related to that. If you have a separate question about it, you are welcome to put it in the chat, but it might not be answered because, again, we want to make sure this is all about audio accessibility. Thank you. All right, so why are we doing this? Why are we here? We have had states and various school districts reach out to us and say that basically they will not be able to allow Boom cards to be used in their schools if we do not meet the compliance. So that is something that we want to make sure to do because, again, more schools equals more sales, equals more teachers for you. So, again, it helps us all around to being compliant with all the things and the expectations that are coming through. And we do want to be here to support you and help you through that way, which is why we are doing this webinar series to make sure that you have the most up-to-date information of how to make your decks accessible on Boom. So thank you so much for taking the time to do this and working through all of these extra steps. It really does mean a lot to us. And we understand it is time-consuming and it does take a lot of dedication to do. So again, thank you, thank you, thank you. All right, so we are going to do a quick FAQ. And then we're going to talk about how do you know when to opt in your deck and when to opt out your deck for audio accessibility. And then we're going to talk through how to add that audio accessibility feature there. And the steps to go through. I will share my screen. We will go through a deck together. And then yep, how to opt in, how to, yep, perfect. And then we'll do a Q&A at the end. So again, if you have questions throughout, please, please, please go ahead and put it in the Q&A at the bottom. Chat might be missed, so I want to make sure that we don't miss those. Okay. All right, so the question I asked on the last webinar, if you did see it, is do we need to have all three accessibility features on all of your Boom decks? The answer is no. You do not need all three if that does not make sense. I know lately I've been getting more questions about SLPs as they don't want the deck to give away the answer, and I totally hear that. So if that's something you want to opt out, whether it's the audio feature to have it read aloud to them, or if it's the alt text, you can turn those features off and make it just motor accessible. however works best for you and your learners. But again, know that the more features that you are turning on for accessibility, the more learners that you'll be able to reach. So that's more classrooms, that's more students, that's more teachers, to make sure that you can have as much accessibility as possible for your decks. Okay. All right, so where to find the setting? So many of you have probably seen on that sidebar, and again, I will share my screen in just a little bit. I've titled this "Find the Length," and it all is one word, right? But then I actually want to add that accessibility text right there. Typically, that's red. I just typed in "Find the Length." And that's exactly what I want. And for me, I did not want this one on autoplay, but you can put it as autoplay and auto pause as well. So it gives it just a momentary pause before it plays it. So that's kind of where we're gonna look at is that sound properties on that right-hand side panel. And again, I will share my screen and show you that as well in a minute. Here's the bigger screen of what it looks like. And so that sound file that's right here, that's where I've put it on all of these same cards going throughout. And again, I'll show you this deck in a moment. And I just typed in find the length. You can add a period at the end. And then I've added this additional description as well for it's a speaker icon or I know some other people have called it different things. I've been calling it a speaker icon, just so screen readers know what that is as well. So that is optional, but does help, again, just more accessibility there. Okay. All right. So let me go ahead and share my screen to get into Boom Cards here. And then we're going to go and pull that deck up right now. I'm going to zoom in just slightly so you guys can see that a little bit bigger. So on my template card is where I clicked and dragged a sound file over. As you saw, here it is. When I click on it, it highlights in the blue box to the right. And that's where I can click to type in find the length and my speaker icon. So this is what I showed you as that screenshot. And you press OK. So again, it's right there. If you don't want to use this sidebox, that's okay, because it's also down here under sound properties, again, under that right-hand side panel. You can change your sound there. I only have these two right here. But again, you can see it says find the length. I know that's what it is. I can hear it if I need it to.
Find the length.
So again, it reads it aloud, so I know exactly what it is. And I click on it to find the link there. And I just type that in. I've been working with some publishers that have been using paragraphs of text. They've re read it aloud. And so you can do that as well. You can type in all of that in there, and that will be audio accessible as well. So again, if you are on the template card, it should come through to everyone. As you can see, it's come through. Here's the next one. Find the length right here as well. It's the same thing, which is great. That's what I want. I want it to come through to all of them. If for some reason you have different directions on each card, you are welcome to change it out. So you can change the sound, click there, find the other one. You can also use your voice recorder, which is right embedded in here. And I'm going to show you that on another deck, but you can just switch it out as well. So that's super convenient there. Let me go back to the other game here. So I do want this to have an audio file for the directions. And my directions are the same on every card, except for my question is not the same on every card. So what I want to do, if I wanted to add sound, I'm just going to click and drag. And I'm going to actually record it right here with you. Pick the correct answers to reveal a picture.
Pick the correct answers to reveal a picture.
Okay, so I can play it back. I can hear that. And that's exactly what I want. I have that voice recorder right in here. I'm going to upload. I'm just going to call it picture for now. But then when I add my accessibility, let's say, great. You see on the right side here, my accessibility is missing. Again, it's the same spot here. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to quick copy And I'm going to put it in here, double click. Okay. And then I'm going to go speaker icon as well. Because again, I just like to add that feature there. But again, that is optional. Okay, so now that is on every one of my carts. Fantastic. So now, if for some reason I wanted this to also be audio accessible, I have to go ahead and drag one more over. I'm gonna have to do a voice record again, or you can upload your own file if you have these already recorded for you. I've done that as well at your own. You can use it with like QuickTime Player or any type of audio recording from your computer, but you can also use the voice recorder right in Boom. Find the happy face.
Find the happy face.
And that's what I want. Happy face. Just so I know what it is, because again, internally, it's going to tell me. I'm going to move this over slightly. Okay. And then I'm going to add my accessibility text for this one. Find the happy face with my speaker icon. Okay. And so that's what you would do for everyone, because now you see it's not on that next card. So you can change it. If you wanted to, you can add a speaker icon to your template card. And I'm going to leave that blank potentially, because then all the other ones will then pop up and I can just change out the sound that I want. So you would just click change sound, add your sound. Okay. But I'm not going to do that because I want to show it on each card. So again, you would just kind of go through, add that alt text there, or that audio accessibility. And that's all that is. I'm trying to think if there's anything else I wanted to show you. I did want to show you how it looks like on the other end. So if I do preview this file,
Find the link.
you can see it pops up with find the length as it read it aloud. So that was the audio accessibility that I have there to find the length. So that's how it would pop up. And if you don't want that, you can turn that off. That'll go right there. That sound to text can turn it right off so that if I go to the next one,
Find the link.
here, once it goes to the next one,
Find the link.
it does not pop up. So that's what you want to show. So that is how you turn that on and off. So now if I go to the next one,
Find the link.
it shows it up here again. Okay. All right. Any questions as we are getting to this? Because that is all I have for showing you how to do the audio accessibility. Back to my presentation here. Go ahead and start putting your questions in. I'm going to get to your action step. So as you are improving content, you want this to be better, more updated, relevant for accessibility. You do want to make sure that you are doing these targets updates by July 1. You can work into July to do that, but we are looking for at least 25 decks in your store that are either brand new that you've like thought about accessibility, you've added to it. Or 25 revised decks. So things that you've gone back and edited to make it even better and more accessible for learners. And any new decks you create from here on out should have at least one accessibility feature because, again, you're just going to reach more students that way. You're going to be able to reach more classrooms, more educators. So that's exactly what we would want for you. And then looking into the future, we are looking at 2026. Either have about 50 new or revised decks, or at least one accessibility feature, or half of your inventory. So if you only have 25 or 26 decks, we only want half of that kind of thing. So whatever is less. If you are feeling confused still, and maybe I haven't explained this accurately, or maybe you just want to talk through some things, you are welcome to email me. My email is right there. You can go ahead and take a screenshot right now or write it down. It's just heather@boomlearning.com. And I'm happy to meet with anybody to discuss these features, whether it's audio accessibility or any accessibility feature. We do want to make sure that you are feeling confident when you are adding those things to your decks. All right, so let's break into questions. Okay, I see a question here. What if you already have a speaker icon and already uploaded the sound file? Does that mean it already is accessible by audio, or is there something else I need to do? So I would say the best answer for that Is just to make sure that when you are in here, if your sound file is not red, then you are good to go. So as you are going through your decks and looking at them, we want to make sure that all the sound files here say what it needs and it's not red. So that's what I would look at as you're going through your decks. Do you want to update the store? Do you want us to update our stores, but it's not always applicable to sellers like speech therapists, totally. How does that affect our store's visibility? So right now, as we've said, like Boom, Premier Publishers are working with schools a lot more closely. So if you are a Premier Publisher, those decks are going to be more prioritized by schools that are looking for accessibility features. But as far as visibility, like in search and things like that, unless a teacher has that filter turned on, looking specifically for those things, it will not impact your visibility. Okay. Any other questions? Those were the last two that I had here. Those were great questions, guys. But again, we just want to make sure that you are getting up to date as much as you can with those accessibility things, just to continue to help you out as teachers are searching for those things. All right. In the past, when I have a deck with cards that all have the same directions, I have added sound directions only to the first card. I state on every card the complete direction. Would it be better for accessibility to have the sound direction on every card, or can it be stated simply? Should I just type it on each card and let the screen reader read the sentence? Hi, Linda. I know you asked that question earlier, so thank you for bringing that up again. I really do appreciate that. Again, going back to here, like this find the length one, I think it depends on your learners. So my background is in special education. So a lot of my students were unable to read, the ones that I had worked with. So for me, I wanted this audio file on all of my decks, because again, my students did not know how to read. And I know there are decks out there that have a lot of maybe changing directions depending on the deck that you were on or the card that you were on. And so I did not want them to be confused, like, for this one, you are trying to find the length. That is exactly what you're doing. Yes, on the next card, you're exactly doing that too. But there definitely is some decks that I've seen where people are changing the directions and changing those things. So again, my background in being in special education, I wanted it on every card. But maybe you're finding, nope, I just want it on that first card to read it, but then they know this is what they're doing the rest of it. I would say if you're gearing your decks towards upper elementary to middle school to high school, yeah, go ahead and put it on that first card. Maybe elementary school, you might want that. Again, depends on the learners that you're working with. So I'm sorry for the vagueness, but it really does depend on what is your target audience. Okay. All right. Any other questions? Make sure that if you are asking questions, they are in the Q&A. So I will give it another couple minutes here. Want to make sure that everybody's questions are being answered, but that is all I have for you guys tonight. And again, if you want to reach out to me, I will put my email back up here for you. So if you feel like you want to reach out, you want to meet with me, I'm happy to meet with anybody. Love it. Okay. Well, thank you, everyone. I appreciate you spending the time here tonight. If you are feeling confused, you have more questions, please, you are welcome to reach out. I am here to support you in whatever way you need. Thank you guys. Have a great night.